Welcome back, Hordlings, to more Dragon Age Origins. Continuing on this Game Hoarder Marathon, Day 2. Got a little tipsy last night, as you may have recognized from some of the previous Dragon Age videos. Plan on doing the same thing again today. Let's head to the village of Haven. Ruh-roh.
Will you stop eating?
I'm hungry.
Stuff your face at camp. For now, watch the bloody road.
Ambush time! Grumpy Bandit. Grumpy Bandit. Chill out. That helps Zevran out.
Now we play a little.
Begin the
Shale just off taking care of business on her own.
Perhaps I could have a try at that.
Get this guy's cunning up some. Might make him a bard eventually. Give him a little bit more use. Lockpicks without a question. Yeah, that's what I thought.
This won't take long.
Berserker! This
Stench of blood and death drives the berserk into a willing fury. Provided a bonus to damage, rage incur a penalty to stamina regeneration, however, with constraint reduces. Which constraint reduces? Resilience adds a bonus to health regeneration in this mode. All the berserker's stamina goes into the single swing. If the blow connects, the attack inflicts extra damage proportional to the amount of stamina lost. So this will be good in conjunction with our mage healing stamina. That could be a good combo with Lug Lug here. Oh, who am I kidding? We're going berserk path all the way. Where his own tainted blood spills in sacrifice, increasing movement speed, attack speed, and critical hit chance for as long as this mode is active. However, the warrior suffers greater damage and continuously diminishing health. The warrior sprays tainted blood in order to knock back nearby enemies. Power of blood. Unlock our bar here. Definitely go aggressive. Need the spirit healer, damn it. Next level. I'm just gonna save my spells for that. Guess I don't need willpower too much. I mean, willpower mainly for deeper mana pool, but she seems to be okay. I think I'm just going to start pumping her magic up crazy. Plus we have the Lyrium potions or whatever. Thinking getting these mage spells might be good as well. I don't know. There's so much to choose from. I don't want to spread out too much. These hexes I hear are good for like the elites and some of the bosses. Man, Death Hex is pretty sweet too. I can get both of those. I don't know, I kind of want to wait and see what I unlock with the spirit. The spirit healer. Devotion, specialization. Sucks that they force you to get Shapeshifter, because I would have definitely went Blood Mage and Spirit Healer. But, oh well. Alright, anyways, cool. Next level is going to be fun.
Watch out, trap there. Make it quick.
What the fuck are you doing? Damn, Lug Lug.
I don't give a shit!
Well, Glug just starts hacking the shit out of people.
Watch out, trap there. Watch out, trap there.
I guess either you can or you can't. Lug don't give a shit. Look at this.
I'll get on it.
Watch out, trap there.
Now's better than later.
All right, Zevran, get your lockpicking ass over there. Make Daddy proud. Take it, we'll sell everything. I'm getting good at selling now. Oh! Snap! Anyways, continuing on to Haven.
What are you doing in Haven? There's nothing for you here.
I have business here!
No, you do not. I would have been informed if someone was expecting a visitor.
Is Brother Genitivi here?
Who? Perhaps revered Father Eirik will know of whom you speak. Unfortunately, he's ministering to the villagers at the moment and cannot be disturbed. I suggest you seek your brother elsewhere.
I suggest you get the fuck out of my way! I would like to explore Haven for a while.
We do not appreciate lowlanders looking about our home as though it was some sort of zoo.
Very well, excuse me.
You may trade for supplies at the shop if you wish. Then I suggest you and your companions leave.
They are hiding something. Tis obvious, is it not?
Ah, quiet insular communities. There's always something nasty going on behind closed doors. I hope it involves chains. I hope they asked me to join in.
Zevran, the little kinky elf. Just a cause.
Yes. On it.
Ooh, another love letter. just read all those once I have them completed.
All right.
Death of a Templar. The dry, dusty earth swallows up salty drops that splatter its surface. A tiny insect pauses, sensing the vibration, and scurries off, leaving behind its invisible enemy. As the drops fall, the dark circles merge together, expressing a mirror to their creator. The primal emotions of bloodlust and sorrow blend into a lethal cocktail that breaks the strongest of men. The jurisdiction of strength must be left to the spirit, not to arm nor chest. Only the wise is turned to his inner sanctuary to partition in the mind from an all-consuming madness, seductive voices whispering promises of glory, waiting down the weaker paths of the flesh, bringing a death far worse than that hot letter steel. These blank, hollow promises will echo the unfathomable eternally. Living comfortably amongst the material possessions, it is easy to misunderstand the true meaning of the uncontrollable hate, failing to understand the power of fighting against pure, unfaltering beliefs against foes that listen only to their soul. Uncontrollable hate. Influenced and thus removed from innocence, the scar is permanent and eternal. The rain, now red, feeds the debt owed for the actions past, seeking further into the earth. As the mind draws slower, what was it that drew him, himself, to the situation? The mind ebbs and parts to a lingering memory of truer innocence. He entered war as a newborn, enters the world, unknowing of both the horrors, the light of the Maker that will save him. The sound of metal sliding against leather comes from above him. From the second he was born to his soon-to-be dying breath, his mind was processing and analyzing knowledge and experiences. It is true that he thought he could be wise in his own eyes, but only the most humble recognizes that he knows very little. Bias, speculation, and all the false pretenses make way to the sound of the sweeping steel, and then finally his soul, as ready as his eyes dry from his final understanding, enters his promise of its purest form. From Death of a Templar by Sir Andrew Knight of Andraste and Templar Archivist. 9-4 Dragon.
Ooh! Shale, you want to step on a chicken?
Speak if it must.
Defensive talents gains bonuses to armor and elemental resistances, while nearby enemies become more likely to target Shale. Nice. Pulverizing blows, precise striking. Rock Mastery. Shale activates a mode that allows ranged talent, attack talents, gaining a large bonus against missile attacks but suffering penalties to defense, armor, and melee. Stone Aura. Shale activates a support mode that imbues nearby party members with bonuses to attack, defense, and health regeneration. I hope she's using that. That seems badass. However, the aura paralyzes Shale and imposes a personal penalty to defense as well as draining stamina. With renewed assault, nearby enemies suffer penalties to attack, defense, and movement speed.
Come, come, Bonnie Lynn. Tell us. Who are you? You shouldn't be here.
Who are you?
I asked you first.
I'm Lugwug.
Lowlanders don't belong here.
Your mama's a lowlander.
What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Tell me what you know or you'll be sorry you ever saw me, you little bitch.
You're the one who'll be sorry. Never trust a lowlander.
I'll fucking kill you, kid.
You do still intend to kill your target, do you not? Is your reputation not on the line?
Are you still on about this woman?
I am led to believe that the crows would never permit such a transgression. They will come after you and enforce.
It has come to my attention that the crows are not always successful when pit against the Grey Wardens and their companions.
Perhaps they will send someone competent next time.
You wound me.
All right.
We have nothing you'd want. Please go.
Doesn't look like there's a whole lot of places to go in around here. When I finally decide to get into some herbalism, I'll have plenty of elf and death root to play with. Shitload of it.
Ah, so everyone is within the chantry. How lovely for them.
So I need flask, huh? That's it. Driven across the Frostbacks in ancient times, the Alamari tribesmen split into three groups. One settled in Ferelden Valley, one was pushed into the Kokari Wilds, and the last returned to the mountains. Modern Fereldens bear little resemblance to their Alamari ancestors, and Chassend remember few of their traditions, but the Avars have changed throughout the ages. Like the Chassend, the Avars are not united people. Each tribe fends for itself and is beholden only to its thing. They still follow their gods, Korth, the Mountain Father, Hakon Winter's Breath, the Lady of the Skies, as well as dozens of animal gods never named to outsiders. Nothing lasts in the mountains. Wind and rain eventually eat away the strongest holds. Valleys that were arable one generation are locked in year-round ice in the next. Game is constantly on the move. Even among themselves, the Var make no absolute promises. They wed by a tradition in which the groom struggles to untie a tightly knotted rope while the bride sings a hymn to one of the gods. However many knots he has undone by the time her song ends is the number of years she will spend with him. Lowlanders often forget that there is no such thing as a permanent alliance in the Frostbacks. Man, that's crazy. Groom struggles to untie a tightly knotted rope while the bride sings a hymn to one of the gods. So if you only get one knot undone, you're gonna lose y'all bitch in a year. Not necessarily a bad thing.
What is it? This won't take long.
Increases the effectiveness of rogue talents. We need to definitely help start pumping up our cunning. That's also why our lockpicking isn't working that well.
Who are you? You're not from here.
Why does everyone tell me that like I don't already know it?
We don't get very many visitors.
Have you seen a man called Brother Gentivy?
No, I've never heard that name.
You're a fucking liar. Tell me about Haven.
How would you describe the place you know only as home?
Touché.
I don't have much, but I suppose you can take a look.
Got a backpack slot?
Nope, fuck you. I'll buy both those. You want to buy some shit? Oh, those are better for Luglug. Keep those. Ceremonial armor. I mean, it's better than my chainmail either way. I should have grabbed the Templar before the Berserker, but I can get it next level, and then I can wear this. We don't do shields. I'm going to hang on to that stuff till I decide. We don't need either of those swords. Alright, thank you. Trying to keep my backpack in a little bit of order here.
What are you doing? That's private.
I'll just take a peek. What are you hiding?
I don't see how that is any of your concern.
I'm making it my concern.
No, you have no right.
I'm fucking Luglug. Fuck you!
How's that for evil, Mr. Satan? Killing shopkeepers and shit.
Perhaps I could have a try at that.
Why do all you people got dead fucking corpses in your house? Something is amiss here for sure. You bunch of shady fucking people. Taking your shit. Thank you. Saving the game. No takesy-backsies. Can I open this now? Oh, the guy didn't have the key on him. Yeah, sure. My ass.
I see enemies ahead.
More of these fucking cultists.
Shall we go on for fights?
Mage versus mage. Oh snap! Oh, earthquake, motherfucker! That earthquake hurt me too.
Lovely.
Sending out multiple shockwaves that damage all nearby enemies and knocks them back. After learning this talent, Shale gains a bonus to armor. After learning. I'm all about that offense. It says no upkeep, but that's from Precise Strikes. Lifestone. Rare rocks have existed in close proximity to Lyrium ore, and as such, they have absorbed some of its traits. Lifestones enhance the natural properties of other materials used in item creation. Crushing a lifestone gives the user a small bonus to nature resistance. Oh. Lesser ice salves increase the user's resistance to cold damage. Alright folks, that wraps it up for this video. Stay tuned for more Dragon Age Origins soon to come. Welcome to the Game Horde Marathon. Get out!